WLBB, and also on the WLBB Facebook page. I'm Seth Cain, Colin Worthington, and Joel Brock in our studios producing the video and radio broadcast this morning. Well, a lot we're going to be covering this morning, and a lot that's going to be happening today. We're going to be talking about the area of sports vision training, and what is it? And you probably have never heard of it before. I've never heard of it before until just a few short months ago, and it's something that a lot of athletes don't think about until they actually get onto the field. They don't realize how much their vision is actually being used while in the field of play. So if you were watching the World Series last night, you know there was a lot of hand-eye coordination going on last night. We have Dr. Rick Tillman of Tillman Eye Center here in Carrollton, along with Price Acker of the Athletic Eye Sports Vision Training Company, and they are joining us in studio this morning to talk about sports vision training and all the areas that go with it, and how you can be a part of it, or how your kids can be a part of it. And we'd like to welcome the guys on the show. Dr. Tillman, Price, good morning.
Good morning. Good morning.
Thanks for inviting us here. And just in case nobody knows, Braves won.
Yeah,
Braves
they won. Did. The Braves did win last night. Wow. First time in 26 years, which is just simply fantastic. It was 4 years old.
I was there
old.
26 years ago. You were? I was four.
No, I was four. I barely remember it. But wow. Well, let's go ahead and dive right in, guys. Let's talk about sports vision training a little bit. But first, Dr. Tillman, let's go ahead and introduce you first. You've been in the field of ophthalmology for quite some time, in optometry, correct?
Yes. We took over Dr. Wayne Brown's practice way back many years ago, we'll just say. So we took over the practice, and really I was interested in sports vision. We do developmental vision for students with developmental problems at school, but I was interested in vision, sports vision training. And actually, when I took over the practice, we approached the Braves, the Atlanta Braves, and was going to have meetings with them, and then the new general manager back then came in and had actually brought in an optometrist with him that did the training, and then the practice started growing, building, and just didn't have the time. And about 2-3 years ago, a lot of my parents' patients, kids that are in travel ball, was saying, you know, how can we get this edge? We want this edge. And then some of my golfing patients said, you know, hitting those 40 years of age and having issues with putting. And it hit me. I have a new son-in-law, yeah, Price Acker. I have another great one across the way here, Seth Cain, the best son-in-laws. And he and my older daughter joined the practice, and I thought, now we can do something. So mm-hmm. We have been developing. With COVID, slowed us down a little bit, but we have been developing the sports vision training, and it's beginning to rock and roll now, and we're really excited. And it is kind of confusing to know, explain exactly what it is.
Because I really don't think a lot of people and a lot of athletes realize how much their vision goes into this. They just say, we just need to see clear. That's all we need to see. But they don't realize that it's just more than just seeing clearly. It's more than having that 20/20 vision. And so more that you've got to dive into. So there's a lot of muscles, per se, in the eyes that you've got to work like you would be working out. And I know, Price, you're the chief trainer for sports vision therapy. When Dr. Tillman approached you and said, hey, we want to get this started. I mean, I know you had to be excited about it, but you're probably at the same time thinking, what is this? So what was it like to you when he first came and approached you with this?
You know, I'm a former athlete. I grew up playing, you know, football, basketball, baseball, soccer. And, you know, when he approached, Dr. Tillman approached me about everything, I immediately thought, this is really cool, because it is a, you know, all sports are very competitive and you're always looking for that edge. You know, you're always looking to see what can make you a better athlete out there, a better performer, to help you, help your team out. And when he approached me about it, I was really excited because, you know, I have a great, you know, deal of passion for sports. I have a great deal of passion for helping people. And I fused both of those together, and I thought, this is a great idea. Let's get it going. And so over the past few years, you know, we've been getting together a lot, and you know, we formed Athletic Eye, and, you know, we got certified you know, we've been meeting with people all over across the globe about people in this industry. And that's what really was really cool is when you really start diving into it and you start, you know, really, you know, talking to all these other ODs and other eye specialists and other trainers. I mean, it is very popular in several spots of parts of the earth. So, you know, I was really excited about diving into it.
And we'll dive more into this here in just a bit of what more sports vision therapy and sports vision training really is. So when you saw that there was a great need a few years ago, was it just like a light bulb just went off and said, hey, we've got something here that we can capitalize on?
I had put it on the back burner, and then all these the travel ball players and they trying to get that edge. And I thought, this is the time now that I've got help in the practice. Let's get this going. And the technology is just out of the roof. We have equipment that helps us with technology that the old school, the sports vision training has been around for a long, long time. Dr. Mm-hmm. Don Teague is kind of the guru, and we actually practiced and trained under him. And we're part of the A-team, which is ODs around the country. Go in spring training and do evaluations, training of different major league teams, baseball, and also there's a contract with the Ladies Golf Professional Association. So it's seeing 2020 is the beginning. It's just the start. We expect that, and we make sure the evaluation or whoever the athlete is, their eye doctor, make sure they've had an updated exam. And when you're going down the court dribbling the ball, or you're trying to pick out the receiver that you're going to throw to in football, you may see 20/20 in an exam room eye chart, but can you pick out peripheral vision, which receiver you're going to throw to, or which basketball player you're going to hand off to, throw to? It's a whole different game. And it can be improved. And really, you don't drop the ball in football because your hands. You drop it because your eyes. 80% of what comes through as far as sports is the eyes. We knew it was going to be, and we've taken off. We've got several athletes now that we're training. So it's fun. It's fun. Mm-hmm. It's something that I love my patients in regular optometry, but this is just a fun thing to do.
Yeah. Well, it definitely is. We're going to dive more into about what the training involves, what sections of the eyes they involve, because we know it involves so much. So we'll talk about that and so much more coming up. You are listening to Community Voice here on News Talk 1330 FM 106.3 WLBB, and also on the WLBB app, which is available now for download on the Apple App Store and Google Play Store. All you have to do is search for WLBB. Brought to you by Oak Mountain Academy and Tanner Health System. This is the Community Voice.
Health is a journey. It's making better choices, even when it's not easy. It's taking care of yourself and the people you love. At Tanner Health System, we're there for you with every step, with primary care, heart care, cancer care, women's care, orthopedics, surgical services, and so much more. We're dedicated to helping you live and feel your best. So let's get on that journey to health. You've got places to be for many years to come. Find us at tanner.org.
As a graduate of Oak Mountain Academy, I've found that my experience on the mountain prepared me beyond all expectations. As a junior at Auburn University, I approached my studies with great confidence thanks to what I learned at OMA. When I think back on my time on the mountain, I think of my teachers. Their genuine love and concern for me as a student was always evident, and now, as an adult, I still foster those relationships. I'm Carly Robinson, an Oak Mountain Academy alum. Visit oakmountain.us to see how you can offer your child an amazing opportunity to be a warrior.
And welcome back to the Community Voice here on News Talk 1330 FM 106.3 WLBB and on the WLBB app, which is now available for download from the Apple App Store and the Google Play Store just by searching WLBB. And remember, if you miss any portion of today's show, you can go back and listen to it in the podcast section on the WLBB app, and it's going to be available immediately after this show is over with today. We're talking with Dr. Rick Tillman of Tillman Eye Center and Price Acker of the Athletic Eye Sports Vision Training, and we're talking sports vision training therapy today. We know if you watched the World Series last night, you know there was a lot of hand-eye coordination going on, but there's just more to it than just seeing 2020 when it comes to using your eyes when you're on the field or on the court. And so we recapped to give an overview of what sports vision therapy was back before we went to the first break of the show. So let's dive deeper into what actually sports vision therapy is. Now, we've heard and know that if you go for a workout, you're training your muscles and you're training them to do so many certain things. So as it, with sports vision training therapy, is that like your eyes training your muscles? That way you're like your eye muscles in a sense?
In a sense, the muscles, but also more than muscles. You can, like in football, you can be in the weight room and you can lift some weights, and then you get out there and the guy runs right past you. You've got to use that ability of the muscles. So we train depth perception, visual memory, the dynamic acuity, which I alluded to before, where 2020 is not enough. You got to be able to pick up the ball when the ball leaves the pitcher's hand, to know if it's a curveball, fastball, whatever. And Price is great at training.
Yeah, so you know, you define that perfectly. It's like if you want to, you know, work on your cardio, obviously you're on the treadmill, start running laps around the track. You want to work out your back, your, you know, your biceps, triceps, your, you know, your chest, you know, your legs, you know. You know, do all those things to get better. Well, this is the same kind of scenario, except it's for your visual system. It's for your vision. And you want to increase things like Dr. Tillman was saying, your dynamic vision acuity. You know, that's when you're in motion or the object's in motion. I mean, how many sports can you think of where you are doing that all the time? You know, you're constantly having to be locked on, you know, laser focused, engaged in something, whether it's the baseball coming at you, you know, getting the ground ball, you know, seeing another teammate making that pass. As a quarterback, you know, we've hinted on a lot, you know, the peripheral when that pocket starts to close in. And then also as a receiver, you know, you have a lot of stuff going on in front of you that can, you know, put stress on your field of vision, but you still got to catch the ball. And so, you know, these are things that we do work on, you know, the reaction time, your depth perception, your eye-hand coordination, getting that balance. Like, these are all things that you can train and you can make better. And if it is something that you score really high on, you know, you want to keep that tool sharpened so your performance can continue to excel.
Yeah, and eye muscles, two things. One, you can have great eye muscles, but them working together, being able to train them to work together. But also, as we age, like the golfer putting, you get into the 40s, 50s, that up-close vision starts to slip, and you can actually improve that.
So, as we're talking about the training aspect, we know there's got to be some tools that are involved with this. So what are some of the tools that you are using that you're using to train? I know there's various tools, not just the simple maybe one or two tools that you're going to have. So what are the different tools that you use to help with this?
Yeah, we'll continue talking more about, you know, the tools and everything, but just like a brief description on, you know, some of the things that we got going on. You know, we have a machine. It's called the Right Eye Machine. And the second tool is called the Synaptech Sensory Station. And then we also have a few other little, you know, additions to those tools. One of them being the Fit Light. They're little pods that we can set up across the room. You can put them on the ground. We also have, by the Synaptech company, once again, we also have strobe glasses that put, you know, a strobe effect into your vision. You actually wear them and you train while wearing those.
Yeah. And then Price loves the Synaptech. Talk about in the database. The pros are in the database.
You know, during the process, you know, you come in, you're interested in sports vision, you know, training. You know, during this process, we want to get your evaluation, and so we use the Synaptech Sensory Station. You know, for one of the ways to get that evaluation started. And it actually goes up into a cloud. After we do the evaluation, it actually sends all your results up into their own personal cloud. And there's everybody from, you know, Cody Bellinger that's done this. There's everybody from Tyler Hero that's done this. People like LeBron James, Steph Curry, you know, all types of, you know, athletes across the board. NHL hockey's really big on this, even in the collegiate level. They, you know, I was actually watching a video the other day, and the University of Alabama has a vision assessment center there at their facility. And so everybody that does an evaluation, it goes show up in the cloud. We actually can compare those results to those guys to help get you the score to figure out what your strengths and your weaknesses are. You know, depending on your age and what sports you're playing, even the position. So it all kind of, you know, combines as one for us to, you know, get a score. And the right eye as an evaluation tool is very similar. It's used as a, you know, percentile to see where you are.
Yeah, we've invested several dollars because Price loves the Synaptic, and I said, okay, we'll get it. But a lot of the universities, major league teams have this stuff. This is the ability, and people say, oh, Lordy, well, if you've invested all this, it must cost a lot. Well, we invested so we can make it. We can have virtual training, people at home. We fit the plan to the athlete, whether it be, you know, high school athlete, college, pro, or the weekend warrior. We can they can come in, we can evaluate, and it will go over the different areas and what they're deficient. And, you know, if somebody's a great player, that's great, but they can always improve. You know, a pro baseball player may improve just a smidge, but that gives them that edge.
Right. So it's anything that they can improve on, which is going to be a great improvement over the course. Now, the different areas that we were talking about, you know, one of the things I think a lot of athletes probably don't realize is the peripheral vision can be the main one, so they can see what's going on from the side of their eyes.
Right.
And with the hand-eye coordination. So how is it, the level of difficulty training you, like your peripheral vision, your and the other areas that you were talking about earlier, can that be pretty difficult?
You know, we like to start off, at a very slow pace. You know, after that evaluation, we want to, you know, just start off. I always kind of, you know, compare it to whenever, you know, I played, you know, in high school basketball. It always seemed like those first 2 or 3 weeks, all we did was just ran. Like we never really shot basketball all that much or layups. It wasn't until after we ran laps and sprints, you know, for about 2 weeks. And this is the kind of the same scenario when we get the process going, is that we slowly kind of go into some things, and we're starting to pick up some stuff about, you know, we had the evaluation, we have your sport, and then once we kind of start seeing some things that, you know, maybe the machines can't pick up on, and we start also, you know, and some, you know, getting some more ideas. You know, it's you know, it's very simple to train, you know, these specific, you know, parts of the visual system, you know, but you want to really get that evaluation so that way, you know, the kind of the blueprint, so to speak, about where you want to go and how you can take it from there.
Okay. Well, we'll talk more about that coming up. And I know a lot of people are going to be having questions of the cost of it and how long can you go for training and things like that. And we'll get that coming up in the next segment. We're talking with Dr. Rick Tillman and Price Acker of the Athletic Eye Sports Vision Training at Tillman Eye Center on Dixie Street, right here in Carrollton, here on News Talk 1330 FM 106.3 WLBB. This is the Community Voice.
Health is a journey. It's making better choices, even when it's not easy. It's taking care of yourself and the people you love. At Tanner Health System, we're there for you with every step, with primary care, heart care, cancer care, women's care, orthopedics, surgical services, and so much more. We're dedicated to helping you live and feel your best. So let's get on that journey to health. You've got places to be for many years to come. Find us at Tanner.org.
Oak Mountain Academy has offered a challenging college preparatory education for 60 years. With over 500 graduates, we have maintained a 100% college acceptance rate. Over 90% of our students earn acceptance to their first choice of college or university, and over the past 5 years, our students have earned over $10 million in scholarship offers. Our students are creating a legacy. Come, be a part of our family and create your own legacy today. To learn more, visit us at oakmountain.us.
It's Community Voice on News Talk 1330, FM 106.3, WLBB, and the WLBB app, brought to you by Oak Mountain Academy and Tanner Health System. I'm Seth Cain here with you on News Talk 1330, FM 106.3, WLBB. We're talking with Dr. Rick Tillman and Price Acker of Athletic Eye Sports Vision Training, a division of Tillman Eye Center on Dixie Street here in Carrollton. And if you, again, missed any portion of the show, you can go back and watch the replay on the News Talk 1330 WLBB Facebook page and listen to the replay on the WLBB app in the podcast section. It'll be available immediately on both platforms immediately following the show here today. So we've been talking about sports vision training. We've covered a lot of ground so far as we're in the final segment of the show. So we need to talk about more about the evaluation process. I know a lot of people are going to say, well, how do you go through evaluations, the cost of it? I mean, everything. That's going to be a big thing because a lot of people are going to think, well, this might be pretty expensive. But the thing is, as we were discussing just a bit ago, that after you do the evaluation, you can cater to their needs as far as cost goes. So how is that all going to be working as far as evaluations and cost are going to go?
Yeah, the evaluation, once we do the evaluation, and if somebody wants to just come by and see the center, and we'll show them the SynapTech, we have a combination of virtual. At home, the SynapTech can be hooked up with a app at home for you to use. We have group rates. We cater around. It can be as inexpensive or as expensive from what the player wants. So we try to cater, you know, with this really state-of-the-art equipment, we're able to do that, which with the expensive equipment that we have, to make things inexpensive for the athlete. And after we finish, you know, it's an ongoing, you don't go and have a coach you. Because we have 6-week, 12-week sessions, and then if you want to kind of have a brush-up sessions or do some things at home, we can rent the app very economically for 6 months for you to use at home. The key is you need to do the homework. And then we don't mess with anything outside the visual system, so we're not competing with the coaches. No. We're getting your evaluation, your last eye exam from your eye doctor. We do not want to take anybody's patient. If you don't have an eye doctor, we can do evaluation at the office. And then it's kind of like the evaluation. Then the first part's kind of calisthenics. Right. We do general stuff. You don't talk about calisthenics.
Yeah. So, you know, kind of going back to what we were talking about earlier, you know, with the right eye machine, SynapTech machine, and then us, you know, taking a look at the athlete and seeing what their strengths and weaknesses are. You know, we develop a step-by-step process. And so you come in, like we've been talking about, you get the exam going, we get the evaluation going, and from there we take your results, your strengths, your weaknesses, your sport, and we're able to put together, you know, a package, a program, like you would have a workout routine or, you know, a cardio routine. Well, it's the same scenario here, except it's with your visual system. We're able to put together, you know, something in place to where you have homework 2 or 3 times a week. You would like to schedule an appointment with us for, you know, at least 60 minutes once a week. And, you know, we have like he was saying, the packages. You know, you can come in after, you know, you do the 6-week or the 12-week course. And we also have other, you know, 90-minute introduction courses that people, you know, kind of get their, you know, their feet wet, so to speak. And this isn't, you know, a once and done, you know, scenario. This is something that, you know, regardless of which one you want to do, you want to keep coming back to do this because it's, number one, it helps you. I mean, it's, you know, it you know, we're seeing results, you know, from athletes that it's really starting to pick up their game. You know, it's really starting to slow down that dynamic of people or objects, you know, coming at them or, you know, them moving forward in a fast-paced environment because that's all done with your eyes. And so, you know, we're really excited about that. And you know, you want to be able to, you know, come back and keep doing it. And it's fun. You know, it's very competitive. You know, while we put together very, you know, competitive training. So if there is some group things, I mean, that's one thing. You know, somebody may, you know, score 25 on something, and somebody may score 28 on something. It's really fun to kind of watch them go back and forth, or you know, even your own personal goal. It's really fun to be there and being involved in that.
And I think, too, you know, getting to see some of the results and how some of these athletes can maybe compare just visually of some of the professional athletes and be like, okay, well, I'm up on par with, you know, like LeBron James, or I'm up on par with Freddie Freeman, Cody Bellinger, you know, all these different guys. You know, I think that's something that would be just at least for me, it would be a cool fact to see where I stand up just visually. With these athletes, I know the SynapTech machine has been able to do that.
It's really cool, you know, and you know, you kind of go in there. You can't pull like LeBron James's score or anything like that. It's all compared to that. But knowing that these professional athletes use this machine, you know, Jarvis Landry, he's a wide receiver for the Cleveland Browns. You know, he's a very big you know, pioneer in the sports vision training industry about wanting to help him do this. Larry Fitzgerald, you know, he's been a wide receiver seems like forever, but he can contributes a lot of his success to this. You know, Steph Curry, you know, you can find, you know, tapes on, or, you know, videos on him, you know, him actually doing this a lot, because it really does slow down the speed of the game and help your overall performance.
Yeah, and you're, if you're a high school athlete, it's going to rank you against other high school athletes, and then as you improve, it won't rank you against LeBron James.
So that's the thing. It's you know, it takes your sport, takes your age, you know, male, female. It takes all that, and that's how it helps rank you and helps us get that score, because the score is based on your results, but it helps, you know, also factors in, you know, other people that have done the same in the exact evaluation as you. So
how athletes describe it is, you know, you've heard, hey, I'm in the zone,
yeah,
or the quiet eye, and that's it. I mean, the baseball looks like this big old basketball coming at you, because and everything slows down. And that's what we're working on.
Well, guys, as we're just kind of getting ready to wrap up, I know there's so much more we could probably talk about for at least another 30 minutes, about 30 minutes to an hour, about how can folks get in contact with you, with the athletic guy, so they can learn more and give a website, phone call, get in contact with you.
Right. So we are a division of Tillman Eye Center, so you can always come by there during business hours. You know, I'm always there. Dr. Tillman, he's always there. Our staff, they've been, you know, trained and knowledged about, you know, answering questions like that. So you can always come by there, or you can reach us at 706-455-0673, or you can email at hello@theathleticeye.com, or you can visit our website at www.theathleticeye.com.
All right, and so it's always going to be available there for you. And of course, again, if you have any more questions, theathleticeye.com, as Price said, is the website to go to. And again, Tillman Eye Center and the Athletic Eye, located on Dixie Street here in Carrollton. You can go by and stop anytime and just inquire about what they have going on. And so, guys, I know you have a lot going on. I know there's so much more that's going to be done, and so much more that's going to be done with the Athletic Eye coming up in the future. It's it's just getting started, but it looks like it's on the up and up.
Yeah, we're excited. Yeah,
we really are. Well, that's going to do it for us here on News Talk 1330 FM 106.3 WLBB here on the Community Voice. And remember, you can catch a replay of the Community Voice on the News Talk 1330 FM 106.3 WLBB Facebook page and on the WLBB app, which is now available for download on the Apple App Store and Google Play by searching for WLBB. Thanks to Colin Worthington for manning the controls in the control room. Joel Brock on video here for us this morning. I'm Seth Cain, reminding you to always be a good sport. Thank you for listening to the Community Voice on News Talk 1330, FM 106.3, WLBB. Have a great Wednesday, and go Braves.